Click on Start Recorder to open the recording window. On the left side of the screen, you'll see the recorder, which is used to control the recording of the test scenario. On the right side, we have a Chrome browser window, which is used for simulating the steps of the test. In the Include Domain window, we enter the URLs of the domain we want to test. This filters out unwanted requests to third-party sites, such as Google Analytics, various ads providers, and so on. Click on Start Recording, a new window pops up. Now we need to press the F12 button for Google Developer Tools in Chrome. This enables the recorder to capture extra information about requests and responses, thus making post-processing and editing of the test much easier. Click on Start Transaction, which will start a new transaction. You can see the generated scenario in the lower part of the screen. Now navigate to the desired website. In this case, we're recording www.smartmeter.io. Transactions group related requests together so that we can measure them as one single unit. When the transaction is over, click on Stop Transaction. Below you can see an updated scenario. The transaction has now stopped. We can add think time, which can also be added or changed later. Think time simulates, for instance, the time a user spends viewing content on the page. Now we'll carry out the same steps again until the test script is complete. When we wish to stop the recording, we hit the Stop Recording button. After the recording stops, we have the option of entering a value for concurrent users and/or full load duration. These are, however, optional and can also be changed later in the scenario. Once we're satisfied with our settings, we can hit Create and Edit Test. This opens SmartMeter.io editor, in which the recorded scenario can be further edited. The SmartMeter.io editor has now started, and as we can see, it contains the recorded test script. More about running the test and changing settings in the next video.